Hi, I'm Brian, this is VentureOut, and welcome to The Hustle.
First time I walked into VentureOut, I was impressed to space. Reminded me of Star Trek in the best way possible.
VentureOut puts you in front of who they believe you should be in front of in their network.
At the end of day one, you're already overloaded with opportunities, introductions. It takes time to follow up in even one opportunity, and you have like 12 of them in one day. VentureOut's model is to make things happen in a week. The challenges are placed in front of you to adapt and to grow. This is VentureOut's first new media program. It's 12 companies, all from different areas of media. We, as Reelwurld, are pretty much the only ones talking about social filmmaking.
Reelwurld.
Good morning. We're really, really excited to have you guys here.
I'm Jan Lucanus, and Reelwurld is our startup. It's a social filmmaking web platform to make movies with the world by gamifying and crowdsourcing the filmmaking process. So that's what we're doing in here.
What attracted me to it to begin with is Jan. We want to redefine what it means to be Hollywood. How do you say that with a straight face?
I have fears. I've always had a fear of building the platform because how can I get the timing right? Because it's all about the timing. What am I going to do?
And we've been working on this for literally years. This startup is literally my life's work. Taking all my learnings from across entertainment and putting it into one particular thing that is a catalyst point for what I see as a redefinition of the film industry. I guess this is my first question. It's having that confidence to be like, you should be putting $1 million into us right now, even though we haven't built anything. Like, what are your thoughts on just that confidence?
Confidence is just trust and belief in what it is that you're doing.
Yeah.
I think, you know.
That's a quote.
$1 million is a lot of money, right? And so to go out there and say to someone for the first time, no, yeah, you're going to give me $1 million and you're going to trust me on how to spend it, is kind of a crazy thing to say to somebody for the first time, right? But that's the next step of the journey, right? This is entrepreneurship. It's the taking a step out into the great unknown.
People that I met in there that I immediately connected with and say I'm going to follow up, it's, you know, there's been a massive step forward for us.
The aspect of, like, someone writing a story and someone animating that story.
Love that idea, that model of going right to the customer first. I asked Matthew a question about how we, as essentially a pre-product company, where we've essentially, because of the nature of the business, have developed a whole bunch of processes before actually writing code. I was essentially saying, because of the fact that we developed all these processes, we have a bunch of prototypes, would we, or work together with a firm like Empire Angels from an investment standpoint? It didn't feel good to hear what he said, honestly. He was just like, well, in New York, you're not generating revenue, then it's just hard. His mentality was that, you know, it's easier on the West Coast to raise cash pre-revenue, and West Coast is becoming more like the East Coast.
I think Matt is right in saying New York venture and New York tech community definitely has more of a focus on having a business model up front, more so than the West Coast does. So it's never gonna feel good to hear that the game is gonna be harder for you. The metrics that you have to hit are higher, or the path that you have to face is gonna be more difficult, but that's just the reality of trying to build something really innovative, right? That, in its essence, is entrepreneurship. Is it someone who can actually go out there and look 1,000 no's in the face and decide to continue going, not to quit? And those people are able to get to 1,001 or 2,000 when they meet those people that actually say yes.
Such a good idea.